Hello friends, in this video we will discuss about ovulation scan. Many patients come to us with repeated episodes of ovulation scans being done and they have a lot of questions. So we will be discussing what is an ovulation scan, what is seen in an ovulation scan, in which patients should we do ovulation scan, in which patients we should not do repeated ovulation scans, and then what is the next process if doing repeated ovulation scan do not work on a patient. So patients come to us with reports. So what is an ovulation scan? Ovulation scan is a scan which is done on a lady which tracks her ovulatory cycle. That is, the scan is done on day 2 of periods, which checks the uterus and the ovaries at their baseline. Then an egg starts forming. Then another scan is done after a medicine being given from day 2 to day 5. Then a scan is done on day 6 or day 7 to look for whether the follicle is growing well. Whether synchronized with the follicle, that is, a follicle is a round structure which is lying inside the ovary, which has fluid in it, which looks black on the scan. And then we look at the size of the follicle to see if the follicle or if the egg has matured. And the egg is a microscopic structure which is roaming inside the follicular fluid. A follicular scan will look at the follicle and it will not look at the egg. So the follicle is seen in the follicular scan, even when it is called an ovulation scan, but it's actually looking at the follicle. So if it is looking at the follicle and the quality of the follicle, but it is not looking at the egg. So a follicle is seen growing from 5 millimeter to 8 millimeters to 14 millimeters to 18 millimeters or 20 millimeters, which is its maximum size. And then this follicle bursts and the egg is released, and sometimes it is not seen to be burst on ultrasound, or sometimes it is seen to have some kind of blood collection in it. Then synchronized with the follicle, we look at the lining of the uterus. So this egg is going to produce some hormone which is going to increase the endometrial thickness, and the endometrial thickness is seen growing proportionately to the follicle. So once the follicle is ready, the endometrium should also grow proportionately to it, synchronized with it, and it should grow to some 8 to 10 millimeters in thickness, in diameter. So patients who have regular periods, they need to do only one index ovulation scan. What needs to be checked? That without any medicine, in a regular cycle, whether this lady forms her own eggs well, the follicle is growing well, the lining of the uterus is growing well, it ruptures well, and then she does not need to do these follicular scans again and again. And she needs to do it only if she has to undergo some IUI process, or it needs to be done in patients for monitoring purpose where they are not having regular periods. The eggs are not being formed regularly, and she needs to take some medication. And why we need to check patients who are on medication? Because we need to check whether 1, 2, or 3 or how many eggs are being formed. If everything is going well, can we trigger this patient? Can we check if rupture has occurred or not? Can we do IUI in these patients? So patients who need to do ovulation scan need to do it for some reason. However, it does not need to be repeated again and again for patients who have regular cycles. So if the cycles are irregular and we need to form the egg, we need to do ovulation scan and again and again. However, if they have regular periods and we have checked one scan and if everything is fine, they do not need to do it repeatedly. Why we lay so much of stress that repeated ovulation scans should not be done? Because psychologically, the patient will have a feeling that a lot of treatment has been done on her, and actually nothing has been done. So patients say that, madam, my ovulation scan was very good and still I did not conceive, pregnancy did not happen. So, but I have 5 ovulation scans, all the scans were fine, the egg ruptured, everything went well, still I did not get pregnant. What is the reason? So in an ovulation scan, there is some 20% information which a doctor has and which helps the patient in conceiving. But the rest 80% is not lying inside the ovulation scan. So what is known in an ovulation scan? Yes, the follicle is good. But the follicle is carrying the egg and we cannot see the egg. We don't know whether the egg is formed of a good quality or not. If the follicle is formed of a good quality, it does not suggest that the egg is formed of a good quality. So we do not know whether the egg is formed of a good quality or not. We do not know whether the tube has picked up the egg. We do not know whether the sperm reached the egg or not, whether baby was formed or not, whether the baby formed came to the uterus and got stuck to the uterus lining or not. We know nothing. So 80% of the information is not revealed in an ovulation scan. So that is why we need our patients to understand that an ovulation scan is just giving 20% of the information. And in this 20% of the information, we will not be able to answer all the questions related to why pregnancy did not happen in an ovulation scan. Another important reason why we tell our patients not to do repeated ovulation scans for no reason in regular cycles is that sometimes some things are diagnosed which do not exist. Like for example, a patient undergoes an ovulation scan and she's told by her doctor that your egg does not rupture or your egg did not rupture in the last cycle. She will get panicked. She will have some kind of confusion that yes, there's some problem inside my body, the egg did not rupture. However, that is not so. The usually, this diagnosis that the egg has not ruptured or this diagnosis is usually not true sometimes. It is not true to some 40 to 50% of the cases. So there's a wrong diagnosis that is made. The problems that do not exist, they come into the picture. So the patients get panicked and then they come to us. So what we tell our patients is that if you have regular periods, if your husband is fine and the tubes are patent and there is some kind of unexplained infertility, and if after, 6 months, 1 year, 2 years, pregnancy is not happening, then we have to move forward. Then we have to go to the next step, either to IUI or to IVF. So we cannot just keep doing monotonously the same thing. The problem is that patients do multiple cycles of ovulation, then they feel that too much of treatment has been done. And when they come to us, we feel nothing has been done. And there is a mismatch of thoughts between the patient and the doctor. They feel that too much has been done. We feel that not much has been done. So in that process, the patient and doctor do not understand each other. So patients should know that ovulation scan in regular periods needs to be done only once. And if they don't have regular periods, then it can be done repeatedly. Those are the patients who do not have a regular period, some kind of hormonal imbalance where they have PCOD and we need to check whether the egg is formed, ruptured or not. So finally, at the end of this video, if you have any questions regarding ovulation scan, you can write a message. Be very happy to reply it, and we can make more videos on topic needed. Then you can write comments and tell us more topics where you want us to make videos. Thank you very much.